Welcome to a thrilling journey where we will uncover the secrets of mastering Sova on Haven. This video is your ticket to becoming a pro, diving deep into the finer points of his gameplay, revealing his strengths, and even exploring his weaknesses. We will equip you with a great understanding of his utility to sharpen your skills and prepare you for the big leagues. So brace yourself and buckle up as we gear up to unravel the mysteries of Sova. Now let's dive straight in. Haven is one of Sova's main maps, and allows you to be flexible with how you use his utility across parts of the map. The main goal with Sova on attack is to take space for your team. Using his kit to help your team by clearing space as you go allows your team to execute onto site much easier. One of the main parts of Sova's abilities is his drone. Using his drone to help your teammates gain space is key when you are trying to execute a site. The five main points of contention on the map of Haven are A long, A short, C long, B site, and garage. Taking control of these areas with a drone and dart is very easy. And as we will look into further later on, taking these spaces can be crucial to winning a round. A long and A short are two of the most important parts of the map to keep control of. A good arrow to help you control long goes like this. Push yourself against this box and aim at this point on the tree and do a one bar dart after the barrier drops. This will clear anyone peeking the close angles on ramp and also anyone lurking behind the concrete stack as shown. One thing to note with this arrow is that the enemies can hide in this corner. But if your team is swinging long, this person will be a sitting duck. Helping your team gain control of A long is crucial when you are planning an A execute. If you stack your team up in short and don't take any space long, it makes it very awkward and forces you to bump heads while you're trying to execute. Also, taking A long space even if you aren't planning on going to A is a great way to force your enemies to rotate and allow for a couple of your teammates to commence a stealth operation and walk on to C site. Taking A short control is just as important as claiming A long control. When you take space on A short, it forces the attackers to either rotate and help the team on A, or the enemies will become paranoid about whether or not you're in there and decide to take information by strolling into your crosshair. Fnatic's Boaster is a particular fan of getting help by Sova to get into this corner in short. While he sits in the corner, their team works on other parts of the map all while this player listens to any rotations. When the timing feels right, this player lurks up and can possibly catch a player off guard, giving the site for free to his attacking teammates. Give it a go with your duo, although it may take a bit of time to learn the timings and make it effective. When you do figure it out, it becomes deadly, and it's only possible because of Sova's utility taking that A short space.
Have you ever asked yourself after a bad game, what am I missing? Or sought help from impatient friends? Or browsed desperately for answers that only bring up more questions? Your self-doubting days are over with Discovery, the first game-focused AI. Discovery is trained on the world's leading esports athletes to be your everyday personal coach. That's right, Discovery can help you improve your gameplay by giving you tips and strategies to take your game to the next level. Get started at ProGuides.com.
Before taking B site, it's recommended to get into this cubby if you are planning to play slow and drone into site clearing to clear the common angles. If you drone from further back in mid, the drone will fall short and you will gain little info. If you're planning to take the site by storm, then it's recommended to do this arrow, which clears most of the site as shown. One thing that many players don't understand is how important pushing all the way through and taking either A link or C link actually is. If you take control of these sections of the map, you'll block the defenders from retaking from that side and possibly catch them by surprise. To allow your team to take A link or C link more easily, throwing a dart into that area or even a drone for your team to follow will set them up to slam dunk on the enemies. Garage is a crucial area of the map if you are looking at which space to take later on in the round. Since many killjoys tend to play towards C, they usually put their turret in garage facing both site and garage door. Occasionally, some killjoys may opt to use alarm bot instead. Using a simple drone or dart to take this space and break utility will force a player on the defender side to rotate over and hold either garage or C, leaving other parts of the map weaker as a result. Being one of the areas of the map where Sova's utility gets less impact, C site does have a small choke point, so drones may sometimes be required if they smoke off the entrance to long. When watching any professional team such as Vitality execute onto C site, they rarely use their drone for taking site, as they're usually executing fast, and they prefer to use a recon dart that can scan all of the site. To do this recon, line yourself up with the right ledge of this window while crouching, look up at the very top edge of this building, and do a full charge one bounce shot. Although taking the site with your drone isn't required, doing a drone similar to this from default while the bomb is down to take space in garage is great, especially since holding garage control forces the enemies to be funneled through CT choke point or succumb to a slaughter in garage. Taking early information in A lobby and establishing control early into the round can be a very important asset to your team. For a good arrow to catch the attackers off guard, push yourself into the center of this brick floor as shown, direct your gaze over to this window, aim at the top right of this window, and do a full charge one bounce. It covers all of A lobby and even a little bit outside of A main as well. If you combine this with a breach stun and omen smoke to cover the entrance, it will allow you to walk up and control the whole space. If you leave one player posted in main, allowing them to listen for information, you can leave to hold the area and focus on stacking other parts of the map. Using Sova as a method of gaining space in mid is a great way to take map control early. It's not something you should be doing every single round, but you can easily catch teammates off guard by doing it once or twice in your defending half. You'll want your duelists to take this space since they can make a speedy getaway if required. To do this effectively, aim your arrow at this point of the wall and do a full charge double bounce. Once your arrow gets a few ticks, this will give your duelist the green light to push down mid. While this is happening, we recommend getting a third teammate to hold your window to allow you or your duelist to get traded if someone swings the window and manages to pick you off. Taking C-long information is great for your team, but is the least valuable part of the map to scan with your dart. Even though you could help a teammate push down into the cubby, you achieve the same goal just by having a player hold long peek with an operator. If you do decide that you want to try and take info on C-long, you can send a dart straight down long without any lineup needed. Even though this space may not be that valuable to take, grabbing it off enemies if they decide to push A or B can be a great way to start a fast flank. A huge thing that I don't see enough Sova players doing is communicating with their operator players. A great asset for any operator player is someone that can help them get a more favorable position where they can get a pick and get away. To help your operator player get into a good position, simply use your drone and arrow to push the enemies away from an area and give your operator player space to get posted in an aggressive position. Sometimes players will get caught off guard by the sudden appearance of the operator and decide to stray away from that side of the map. Another reason it's great for the operator player to get into a more favorable position is because it allows them to hold that part of the map all by themselves, giving their teammates the opportunity to rotate off that site and stack elsewhere. We'll wrap up this guide with a retake dart for each of the three sites. To start an A retake, come to anywhere around this point in A link. Aim at the corner of this building and do a full charge shot. This will clear almost all of site, with the only exceptions being under heaven and deep in A short. For a B retake, position yourself in either A or C link, and then send a dart that lands anywhere on this front wall above the entrance to clear all of front sight, since you will be able to see back sight from the link anyways. Finally, for a C retake, nudge yourself into this corner in C link. Aim up so that the top right corner of your charge bar lines up with the intersection of these two rightmost flags. Give it one bar and shoot to clear almost all of the sight. And that's gonna wrap it up for right now. Hopefully you enjoyed this in-depth Sova guide for Haven and can use it to better play the agent in ranked. Make sure to hit that like and subscribe, and don't forget to ring the notification bell to be the first to watch our videos. If you want more tips to become an even better Sova player, make sure to check out ProGuides.com, and we'll see you guys soon.